Hi everyone, my name is Shivani Kapoor and I work with Societe Generale Global Solutions Center as Associate Vice President. I have a total of 12 years of experience, predominantly has been in HR business partner domain. In my career, I've got opportunities to work with diverse set of industries, including financial services, e-commerce, education sector. Been a consultant also for a short span of time. I'm a keen learner and someone who's always interested in learning and understanding human psychology. One such opportunity that inspired me to do this project in the area of recruitment and selection on this project called Coach. Coach, that's a Hindi word which translates to search in English. In this project, I actually got an opportunity to master three psychometric assessments and leverage on them to identify the best fit for an open critical position in a mid-sized organization, which is actually in its growth phase. I would like to share some insights from the research that has been conducted on the brain science that actually has enabled all of us to learn more about the way our brain functions, especially in the past few years, as compared to in the past that we've ever known the functioning of our brain. Basically, our brain has three parts. One is our brain stem. Second is our limbic brain. Third is neocortex. The brain stem, it is also called the reptilian brain. It is at the base of the skull, emerging from the spinal column. This part of the brain controls breathing, our heart rate, or our instincts like your fight and flight response when danger threatens. It also controls other primitive instincts, such as the sense of our territory. You may feel angry, you may feel uncomfortable, you may feel threatened when someone moves really close to you. The second part of the brain is the limbic system, or it is also called the mammalian brain. This part of the brain is the emotional controller. It also helps to maintain a stable environment within our pleasure centers, our metabolism, our immune system, also a part of our long-term memory. To this part of the brain, emotions really appeal and work much better than the rational arguments to influence any human behavior. The third part of the brain is neocortex. It is also called our thinking brain. This is the part of the brain where intelligence lies, and it makes us humans as unique species. The neocortex handles seeing, hearing, creating, thinking, and talking. Actually, in fact, all the higher level intelligences. This brain has all the capacity that you will ever need to learn and remember anything that you want. Neocortex actually is divided itself into specialized parts, which are called lobes, for speech, hearing, vision, and touch. With this as basis of understanding of human brain, in this project, I also worked on understanding the competencies required for the job role that we are willing to fill in, that is senior manager strategic planning with ABC Technologies. Please note, I have intentionally masked the name of the organization. These competencies are primarily divided into two: functional and behavioral. Functional competencies, as we all know, form the tip of the iceberg that is clearly visible and therefore easier to assess. Whereas the behavioral competencies are below the waterline. These are more difficult to assess and often harder to develop. These competencies can be understood as manifestations of how one views himself, which is called his self-image. How he or she could typically behave, which is called trait. And the third one is his or her potential to learn new skills needed in a new job is called his abilities. In order to assess these competencies, we had detailed interviews with the leadership team at ABC Technologies to understand from them the functional as well as behavioral expectations from the incumbent in this role. These inputs actually helped us arrive at a detailed job description for this role.